Sairam, let us continue with the revision of chapter number 8, comparing quantities. Today we will again do some more important questions of this lesson. So first question, convert each of the following into decimal form. So these are the questions, 25.2%. You can see it is given in percentage and you have to convert it into decimal form. It is also given in decimal form, but you have to again convert it into decimal form. We'll have to remove percentage. And the next is 0.15%. Third one is 25%. So let us start with this 25.2%. So you know percent means what? You have to multiply it by 1/100. So 25.2 into 1/100. So it will be 25.2/100. And then what you will do? You will have to take this decimal to the left side because you are dividing it by 100. So point will go to the left side by how many places? As there are 20, so it will go to the left by 2 places. So you will get 0.252. Now next is 0.15%. So it will be written as 0.15/100. And then again here 2 zeros are there in 100. So point will be shifted to the left by 2 places. So here one, you can see here it has shifted to 2 places. So one more zero is given here and then point has reached here. So it will be 0 point. If you want before point, you can give one zero. So 0.0015. Now third one is 25%. So it will be written as 25/100. So we'll remove the percentage first. So 25/100 and then you will convert it into decimal. So here two zeros are there. So point will shift here. So you will get 0.25. Now next question. The cost of 4 meter of cloth is rupees 40. Find the cost of 9 meter of cloth. So this kind of question you can do by unitary method also or by ratio method also. So today we will do this question by ratio method. So let us see how to solve it. See children, this is the way to solve. First, what is given? It is given the cost of 4 meter cloth is given. That is rupees 40. And you have to find out the cost of 9 meter cloth. You can do it by unitary method also. This is another method, ratio method. So how we will write 4 meter here? 4 is to 9. This is 9 meter. And that is equal to, and we know the cost of 4 meter cloth, that is rupees 40. So here is equal to 40 is to, and we don't know the cost of 9 meter cloth, which we have to find out. So we will assign here one variable, that is x. So 40 is to x. Now you know as it is given here, as we have written ratio, so we'll write 4/, we'll write in fraction form, 4 division here divided, sign will come, divide 4/9. Either you can give division sign or you can write 4/9. Ratio is there. So is equal to 40/x. And then what you will do? By cross multiplication, you can get the value of x. So 4 will be multiplied by x. So you will get 4x. And 40 into 9 is 360. And then what you will do to get the value of x? 360 will be divided by 4. So you will get answer 90. So you will solve this all question in your maths notebook. These are very important questions. So try to solve by this method also. So this is very easy. Now next is compare the following ratio. So here you can see 3 ratios are given and we have to compare and we have to arrange it. 3 is to 4, 5 is to 6 and 3 is to 8. So first we will write down this in fraction form. So how we'll write 3 is to 4 is 3/4. Or we can say 3 divided by 4. 5 is to 6 is 5/6. And then 3 is to 8 is 3/8. Now children, you can see here all the denominators are different. So what we'll do? We'll take LCM of 4, 6 and 8. So LCM of 4, 6 and 8 will be 24. Now what we'll do? We are going to equalize the denominators of all this. So first we'll write 3/4. So as 4 is there in the denominator, so what we are going to do? We are going to multiply by 6 because 6 fours are 24. We have to get 24. So here when you are multiplying by 6, here also in numerator we have to multiply by 6. So you will get 18/24. Now we will take the next one, next fraction, 5/6. So here we have to get 24 again. 6 4s are 24. So here also 5 4s are 20. So you'll get 20 upon 24. Now third one is 3 upon 8. So here 8 is there in the denominator. So we are going to multiply it by 3. Here also 3, here also 3. So we will get here 9 upon 24. Now what we'll do? We will arrange it in ascending order. First the smallest one is 9, then 18 and then 20. Now in place of it, we will write down the fraction here. Here 9 upon 24, then 18 upon 24, then 20 upon 24. Or you can directly write like this also. And then we will write on the original fraction, that is here. 3 upon, you can see here, 9 upon 24 we have got here, that is 3 upon 8. So here first, this is the smallest one. Then we will write on the next one, 18 upon 24 we have got from this fraction. So we'll write 3 upon 4, this is the original one. Then we will write this one, this is the largest one, 5 upon 6. And then we will write on the ratio, 3 is to 8. Is the smallest one, then 3 is to 4 and then last is 5 is to 6. So this way you are going to compare the ratios. Now children, one word problem. The cost of an object is increased by 12%. If the current cost is rupees 896, what was its original cost? So first what you have to do, when word problems are given, we will write what is given in the question. So here the cost of an object is increased by 12%, that is given first, and the current cost means present cost is rupees 896, this is also given. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out the original cost. So let us see how to solve it. See here, first we will write rate of increase in cost, which is 12%. So 12% there is an increase in the cost, and then increased cost after this rate of interest, it will be rupees 896, which is given in the question. Now what you have been asked? You have been asked to find out the original cost. So here we will give question mark. Now we have to assign, here we will take x. So let the original cost be rupees x. So we will assign a variable here, rupees x. And then increase in cost is how much? It is given as 12%. You can see here, we have written whatever is given in the question. So it is 12% of x, because this is the original cost. So on this, there is an increase in cost. So it will be 12% of x. So which can be written as 12 upon 100 into x. That is 12 upon 100 x. Now increase cost of the object will be on cost price. Because the cost price was how much? It is x. We have assigned one variable for that because we have to find out the original cost. So we will take it as, we have taken it as x. So x plus 12 upon 100x. And then you know how to solve it. If you take the LCM here, you will take the LCM of 1 and 100. You will get 100. And then 100x, you will cross multiply 100x plus 12x. 100x plus 12x, you will get 112x upon 100x. So you are going to solve this. So you will get 112x upon 100. Now next what we will write? 112 upon 100x is equal to, because they have given the current cost now after the increase by 12%, the current cost is rupees 896. So we will write that 112 upon 100 x is equal to 896. And then you know how to find out the value of x. We'll write x here first, 896 we'll write, this will take it to this side. So we will write down first here 100 will be here in the numerator place and this will be in the denominator place. You have to write this in reciprocal form. And then what you will do, you know, you will this thing reduce it. And you can see here, when you reduce this to, you will get 8, and 8 into 100 is rupees 800. Children, practice all these sums again and again, then you will understand. Now next, one more word problem. Radhika borrowed rupees 12,000 from her friends, out of which rupees 4,000 were borrowed at 18% and the remaining at 15% rate of interest per annum. What is the total interest after 3 years? So here what we have to do? we have to find out the total interest. First, whatever is given, we will write. So let us write and see how to solve. Total amount borrowed by Radhika here, rupees 12,000. So she borrowed rupees 12,000 from her friends. And the amount borrowed by her at 18% per annum. You can see here, for rupees 4,000, there is an interest of 18%. So here rupees 4,000, here you will write. You will not write here 12,000, because for 4,000 there is an interest of 18%. So first we will find out this part. So interest is equal to P into R into T upon 100. You know this formula, we have learned. So in place of principal, we'll write 4,000. And then in place of rate, what we'll write? 18%. 18, and then time is how much? Time, you can see here, 3 years. So here 3 upon 100. And then you are going to solve. You are going to cut this to 0. And then when you will multiply, you will get this value. Rupees 2,160. Now how much is remaining? Remaining amount, how will you get? You have to subtract this to 12,000 minus 4,000. So we are going to subtract this two values. So when you subtract, what you will get? You will get rupees 8,000. So on rupees 8,000, what is the rate of interest given? 15%. So we will write here, P we will write as 8,000, because here what is left after subtraction, we got 8,000. So we'll write 8,000 into here, rate of interest will change. Here it will be 15. And then again time will be same, 3 years upon 100. And then you are going to solve it. On solving, you will get rupees 3,600. Now the question is, you have to find out the total interest. So this is one interest and this one is another interest. So both the interest, what we are going to do? We are going to add it. Then only we will get total interest. So rupees 2,160 plus rupees 3,600 will be rupees 5,760. So this way you will get the total interest. Now next question. The simple interest on a certain sum at 5% per annum for 3 years and 4 years differ by rupees 82. Find the sum. So here what you have to find out? You have to find out the sum. So you know sum means you have to find out the principal. So we have to assign a variable for sum. And then here differ is given. Differ means difference. So let us see how to solve it. So first we will write, let the required sum be rupees P. So we have assigned P as a variable here because we have to find out the principal. And then simple interest, first we will see what is given for 3 years. So simple interest for 3 years we'll find out. And then we will go to the next part, that is 4 years. So let us see. As you know, the formula for simple interest is P into R into T upon 100. So here is equal to, as we don't know principal, so here we'll write P. We have assigned P here for principal. So we'll write P into 5. 5 is the rate of interest, you can see here given 5. And time here, number of years will take 3 upon 100. And then this 2, when you reduce, you will get here 20. 25 is 100. So you will get here rupees 3p upon 20. Then we will take the next part, that is for 4 years. Simple interest for 4 years. So again we will write down the same formula for simple interest. P into R into T upon 100. Now we will write is equal to P. In place of R, what we will write? R is same, 5. In place of T, we will write 4. 4 years upon 100. And then again, what we will do? We are going to reduce this. So when you reduce this, you will get 20 here in the denominator. So 4 into P is equal to rupees 4P upon 20. Now children, you see here what is given? Differ is given. So you know differ means difference. You have to take the difference of this two. This two. Okay, so this two interest we have to see. The simple interest, you have to like differ by this much money, rupees 82. So we have to take the difference. So we'll write 4p upon 20 minus 3p, this is 3p upon 20, and that is equal to, what is the difference given? 82. So we'll write is equal to 82, and then we'll solve it. So as the denominator is same, so 4p minus 3p, you will get p, and in the denominator we'll write 20 upon 20, and that is equal to 82. And then what we'll do? To get the value of p, we have to cross multiply. So 82 into 20, you will get rupees 1640. So hence the required sum is equal to rupees 1640. Now children, this is your homework for today. These are the questions which I have discussed last time also, and this time also I have taken some questions. So practice all these questions in your maths notebook. That's all for today. Thank you.